Hi everyone, in this video, I'll introduce you to the basics of scenario-based e-learning using Articulate Storyline 360, in addition to options to add assessment to your module. For this video, I'll be using a simple scenario based on a scenario I had previously created using a different tool. To provide some context, this scenario was designed to complement in-person training, so the file that you can see here only includes the scenario itself, including a trigger event, some decision points, and two different outcomes. The story view will be very helpful in the scenario-based e-learning creation process, as it allows you to visualize all the branching options you included in your module. In my case, I have three different branches. The two less than ideal decision branches eventually converge, and learners can also deviate from the ideal path by choosing the least ideal option for the second decision point. Now let's look at the module design from the beginning. You can see here that I have on-screen buttons for navigation, and learners will use these buttons instead of interface buttons throughout the module. Guidance on how to create these buttons was presented in the previous video. Slides 1.2 and 1.3 contextualize the scenario. Slide 1.4 introduces a button that learners can click on for an external resource that will assist them in making decisions throughout the module. You'll see here that I have a trigger for this element that leads to a PDF document on the web. Slide 1.5 introduces the scenario. Slide 1.6 presents the first quote-unquote decision. Only one decision button is provided, however, as the purpose of this button is to introduce learners to how on-screen options for decisions are presented. More context and information is presented, and in slide 1.9, learners are faced with their real first decision. Note that in this slide, I didn't include a next button because the slide that comes next will depend on the choice that the learner has made. For example, clicking on button 1 leads to slide 1.14. Let's click on Edit Trigger so you can see how this is set up in Storyline. When creating buttons in our last video, we set the buttons to advance to next slide since the interaction there was linear. In this case, since this slide will branch out, we will specify the number of the slide we want this button to take us to, slide 1.14. You will do the same for each and every option on screen. As you can see here, we have for buttons 2 and 3. Note that since you are selecting a specific slide as the destination for the trigger, that slide needs to have been previously created. Let's go back to the story view. My approach is to create the first follow-up slide for every possible decision, and then create the trigger. For instance, it was after creating slide 1.14 that I added the trigger for button 1. You will do so for each possible branching option and all of your decision slides. The process of creating triggers that lead to branches can become somewhat confusing, especially if you're developing a complex scenario with many different branching options. For this reason, before actually diving into the development process in Storyline, I recommend mapping out your scenario and the different branching options using a tool like Twine or diagrams.net. Now let's look at the process for adding assessment in Storyline. Though knowledge checks are not included as a required component of the module we'll be creating for your final project, you might want to include assessment depending on the content that you're covering. Let's create a simple assessment slide right after our title screen. Right-click the Scenes tab, go to New Slide, and choose Graded Question. You'll see that there are other options you can choose from, such as survey and freeform questions. After you select graded question, you'll be taken to the screen that presents all of the assessment options built into Storyline. You can, for instance, create true or false questions, fill in the blanks, drag and drop, and multiple choice questions. If you scroll down, there are some design templates that you can choose from if you are creating a basic multiple choice question. That is what we'll do. We'll choose a template and click on Insert Slide. After your slide is created, you'll see this screen. This is the form view, which allows you to focus on the actual content of the slide without the design components. I recommend using this view to actually create your questions and feedback. You can also use the slide view, which allows you to edit the visual components of your slide. For now, let's go back to the form view. When editing your question, you also have access to this question tab, which allows you to set specific parameters for your assessment, such as whether feedback is provided by question or by choice, if answers will be shuffled, if a result slide will be provided, how scores are calculated, and how many attempts learners have. I'll quickly create a question here and customize its options and visuals. Let's look at the question tab. I set feedback to be provided by choice, so learners get specific guidance depending on the option they choose. There's no shuffling, since the correct answer refers to the positioning of the two other possible answers, A and B. No result slide is provided, and score is calculated by question. Attempts are set to unlimited. Always keep the intentionality behind your assessment when setting these question parameters. Here, in the slide view, you will see that layers have been created for feedback. Storyline does that automatically for you if you create an assessment following the steps I am providing. Since specific feedback is provided for each choice and we have three possible responses, we have three different layers. The triggers in both incorrect layers are set to hide this layer, as you can see over here, and only jump to the next slide if the learner has selected the incorrect response for this question 10,000 times. This number would change to 3, for example, if you wanted learners to only have 3 different attempts. For our purposes and considering our design, this trigger is not actually necessary, so we'll delete it. If learners select the correct answer, the slide advances upon clicking on Continue. Let's see how that works in practice. We'll preview our file and proceed to our question. Click on Next in our title slide. And let's first select an incorrect response. Click on Submit. And after we click on Continue over here, we're given the option to try again. The same thing will happen after choosing the other incorrect answer. Now, if we choose the correct option, the slide advances upon clicking on Continue. Let's close out our preview. These are the basic processes for creating learning scenarios and assessment for your Storyline module. Though the processes that we covered here may seem rather simple, the basic idea behind the design of these interactive components in Storyline does not change in essence, even for more complex assessment options, such as drag and drop activities. That said though, don't hesitate to reach out if you need more specific guidance.